To my brothers and sisters in the EPC family of churches, grace and peace to you in our Lord Jesus Christ. I come to you as in what may very well be a Kairos moment in the life of our church. I come to you in a pastoral capacity as your stated clerk. Many of you perhaps have heard about what seems to be a genuine outpouring of the Holy Spirit in the campus of Asbury University in Kentucky. And now, some 9 or 10 days in, that same outpouring seems to be pouring out onto other campuses across the country. A number of people have gone to Asbury to observe what is going on, including someone that I dispatched there a couple of days ago, an EPC pastor with a long history of studying the historic revivals of the Christian church, and he himself someone who for some 30 plus years has been praying for an outpouring of the Holy Spirit with tremendous discernment and a heart open to the movement of the Spirit in this regard. We have been hearing stories of repentance, of reconciliation, of testimonies of people coming to Christ. And some of the words that have been used to describe what's going on the campus are a gentle power, that it's orderly. It doesn't seem to be given to a kind of a emotional fanaticism. And so that warrants us doing a couple of things. One, having somebody on the ground to observe what is going on, because I've learned in 36 years of pastoral ministry, it's way better than trying to make stuff up and invite people to what we're doing. It's way better to observe what God is doing and invite people to go join him in that activity. And if this is a work of the Lord, then we want to join God in what he is doing. And so number one, we want to have somebody on the ground giving us updates on what's happening, and we have that. Number two, I'm going to encourage all of us to what I call the Gamaliel principle from Acts chapter 5. That is to say, if this is of man origins, it will fizzle out and go away. But if this is of God, we dare not oppose it. We may find ourselves opposing God. And so rather than rushing to judgment one way or the other, I think it would be wise for us to have discernment, to lean in. And the third thing is simply to pray. I think if nothing else, gathering together as a congregation to pray is always a good thing. But what if we gathered together and prayed and poured our hearts out to God for such a time as this, that the Holy Spirit might come and bring us to repentance and bring us to reconciliation and bring others to the gospel? What if this is that moment? I would hate for us as an evangelical Presbyterian church to miss it. We've been hearing stories of gospel conversations and people coming to Christ, and now this outpouring of the Spirit on the campus at Asbury University and others leads me to come to you and say, would you at least, if nothing else, pray? My prayer starts with this: Lord, may revival begin with me. Set my heart ablaze for the things of your Spirit and your word. And if each of us prayed that prayer and gathered our congregations to pray similar prayers, who knows what the Lord would do. And whatever he chooses to do, may it be to his glory, honor, and praise, as we all unite in that ancient prayer crying out to him, Maranatha, come, Lord Jesus, come.